stop.
Many stop.
Never take a short from Brooklyn. What you do here is not a test.
Ooh, baby, I like it, girl.
Here we mix.
Herzlich willkommen zum Mixi Raw Deluxe. Heute hier in New York City. Wir haben heute ein Rocker-Special. Die Macher von der Lyricist Lounge werden wir interviewen. Einige Artists, welche das sein werden, bleibt erstmal ein Geheimnis. Erst wenn ihr wieder einschaltet, werdet ihr es erfahren. Der Mann zu meiner Linken ist Falk, der neue Moderator der Hip-Hop-Show von Viva 2. Supreme wird sie heißen. Was erwartet uns da?
Hip-Hop, straight up Hip-Hop.
So wie bei uns. Vielleicht noch mal ein bisschen was hier zu eurem Konzept noch irgendwie, ein paar Worte.
Wir kommen viermal die Woche, von Sonntag bis Mittwoch, von 22 bis 23 Uhr. Und lasst euch überraschen, schaut es an, ab Januar.
Genau. Ist ja auch dein erstes Mal in New York so?
Ich bin das erste Mal in New York. Bin geflasht, ist cool hier.
Okay, und wir beide werden nachher die Interviews führen durch die ganze Show. Ich hoffe, ihr werdet euren Spaß haben, weil wir werden es auf jeden Fall haben. Weil man einen kleinen Hintergrund-Einblick in die New Yorker Underground-Hip-Hop-Szene ist nicht schlecht. Deswegen bleibt dran, wie immer Mixi Raw Deluxe. Und jetzt kommt noch ein Video, was er ansagen wird, seine Premiere als Video-Ansager heute hier bei Mixi.
Wir sehen Talib Kweli und Hightech mit Reflection Eternal. Das ist neu.
Nicht das Neue, aber das Video.
Das Video.
Get 'em up, get 'em up, why? Get 'em up, get 'em up, why? Get 'em up, get 'em up, why? Yeah, 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 yeah. What's with the melodrama? Fellas wanna hover in my cypher like a helicopter. Like it's a special honor. The stealth bomber, jam dropper, make the ghetto holler. Enter, continental. Taking you high like skydivers when we spark the fly wires. Original, caveman quest for my fire. Express my desire to drop this new shit. Come on. These record executives keep telling me I'm stupid. Now if they right, shut the fuck up. Revolutionary, throw your guns up. Whether you a bougie broad who acted stuck up or some ignorant thug motherfucker shooting the club up, we gon' make y'all feel this. Break y'all spirit if y'all fake that realness. Word, we bringing it in from the new millennium to way after that. I call these cats rentals cause they plastic wrap. Kill all the yapping, let's make it happen. You cats ain't real, y'all just a reenactment. Better yet, dramatization. Soon as the director say action, you start faking. I start breaking. The whole joint starts shaking. This ain't the time or place for you to prove something. Got the stargazing, yo, move something.
Move something, move something, move something, move something, move something, move something.
Word, word. Alright, bring it back to the top.
To be continued. Let's see what's next up on the menu. Run up in you. Lyrics that be fucking with you. In the mental. Pick any mental. Instra, funda, detra, extra, extra large. Like the borough of Brooklyn, the residential. Extra, central. This specialist like Sly Stone with my poems and fly song. Ride along with cats who live great and die strong. Word. We gonna rock till nothing else matters. Y'all catch bodies, we catch excellent cadavers. You're next to kin and shatter. Stories splattered in the tabloids. Erase your trace like you cotton mouth and we peppermint Altoid. Stepping the high, repping the spot, called Flatbush. Whether rappers or actors, you still feel the gap bust. The abstract then becomes the reality. Alcoholics like to call it the moment of clarity. Kill all the yapping, let's make it happen. Cats ain't real, y'all just a reenactment. Better yet, dramatization. Soon as the director say action, you start faking. I start breaking. The whole joint starts shaking. This ain't the time or place for you to prove something. Cut the stargazing, yo, move something.
Move something, move something, move something, move something, move something. Move something. Move something.
What?
Flatbush, Brownsville, Best Dot, move something. CA shot in West Side, cause move something. Cincinnati in the house, you got to move something. In the dirty South, got to move something. The South Bronx, 125, move something. Q-Burl, make it live, cause move something. Miami on the way to Philly, got to move something. Chicago in the Brick City, got to move something. My soul rebels in the world, you got to move something. B-Boys and B-Girls, got to move something.
Ooh, baby, I like it, boy.
Here in the mix.
Oh, the Lyricist. All night, Sunday, Central. What love it up. Listen, say hi, Dick, yes, you're rolling hip hop. Say J Roll, just you're rolling hip hop. Redefinition, say you're rolling hip hop. Say like so, come to rock it up. One, two, three, most every time, live while it begins. Begin to rock it on to the tip top. Best alliance in hip hop, by all. I said, one, two, three, it's kind of dangerous to be a MC. This shot to park and reggae. Hold your head when the beat drop, by all.
Bring hip, hip, hop, hop back. Bring hip, hip, hop, hop back. Bring hip, hip, hop, hop back. Yo.
And bullshit and party.
Go for it. Shit, it's the remix.
Yo, Big Sweet Raw Deluxe jetzt hier mit den Honors von der Lyricist Lounge, Danny und Anthony.
Yeah, what's skating?
Losing.
Nice to have you on our show.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, you started very early. You heard this question 1,000 times before. You were 16. But what was the idea behind the move to check out the Lyricist Lounge?
Yeah, I mean,
what was it? What kind of time was that?
Yeah, the main objective for Lyricist Lounge was to do an open mic. So we started open mic sessions like back in 1991 over in the Lower East Side, Manhattan,
New York City,
in a small studio apartment. And you know, we just had open mic sessions like every week on a weekly basis. You know, we invited friends of ours to come down and rehearse their lyrical skills, you know.
Okay. Was it mostly written lyrics or freestyle or both? Or
it was really whatever came to their head, you know. If they wanted to do written, it was up to them.
Okay.
If they wanted to do freestyle, you know, it was like a rehearsal space for whatever you wanted to do, you know.
And how many MCs were on one session?
Yeah.
Like 20 or...
Yeah, around
20?
When we first started, it was like three.
Three.
Me, Danny, and one other person.
Yeah.
That was it, you know. And
then the pioneers of the first night.
Yeah.
This is Lounge Session.
Yeah.
Smooth.
Yeah.
And then it gets more.
Yeah,
and
elevated.
I know from experience that when there is a freestyle session and you got like 20 MCs and they're all hot and hungry and everybody wants to step to the mic. Who was the organization to say, Smooth, you got your part and you got your part, how deal with that?
It was really natural, you know what I'm saying?
It was like, really natural. Like
everybody
first,
gave each other
was
time.
Cool.
Yeah,
it was like a cipher. Like, you know, when everyone gets in a circle and they start rhyming,
they take turns.
That's exactly how it was. We just had microphones and we was just like, all right, you go now.
Mm-hmm.
And then they'll go and they'll do it like that. But once more and more people started coming, like once it started
talking around, everybody was talking.
Then we had people sign a list. You know, it was first come, first serve on a list.
Right, exactly.
Okay, the first 20 could get...
Exactly, get like 2 minutes or 1 minute. One verse, pretty much, you know. You go on, kick one verse, and then pass the mic.
Okay.
Yeah. Did you check the people before they go on stage? Back in the day, so.
Not in the first venue, you know. When we moved to the bigger venue, then we were like, yo, we can't have so much people coming here just getting on the mic. So we told people to send us tapes, and we review the tapes, and then we'll call you back, and then you could perform.
Some of the big people today started out at your Lyricist Lounge, like Biggie or Eminem or Rod Digger. When you met them, you saw that this guys and girls gonna blow up in the next years?
Yeah, we kind of figured that they will blow up because they just had this, like, this aura about them, you know, that it was just, like, amazing. You know, they stood out from the rest, you know, like Biggie Smalls, like his energy and his delivery. Like, he just, like, controlled the crowd every time he performed and stuff like that, you know, and, you know, other people.
It's incredible, man. I mean, yeah, we definitely were blessed to meet some of these people at a real good time, you know, in their life before they really took off. Like Danny said, you know, people, meeting people like Biggie, that's like a memory that I'll never forget, you know what I'm saying? Like having him on our stage, you know, doing like fake, you know, like there's a part in the song where he's like, it talks about a fight, you know what I'm saying? In the song, he's like, yo, hold on, chill. So he actually did that in the show and had like street promoters act like they were fighting. And it made this whole rough one, and he was like, can't we just all get along? So it was just memories, man, it's deep. But people like Biggie was incredible. Meeting people like Eminem before he took off was big, you know what I'm saying? Just hearing his tape and hearing how ill he was and how he put his lyrics together, that was an incredible thing. And bringing him on tour with us, you know, was just as big. People like Rod Digger, you know, she was beautiful, incredible, performing at our show while she's pregnant, you know, at 3 in the morning, just being really hungry and really wanting to get on, you know, was big, you know. Mm-hmm. Q-Tip signed her right from there, you know, like, yo, I like her.
Okay.
And then she moved over to Busta, so, yeah, man, we've been blessed. Man.
So, we got a wish clip on our show, and we'll talk about it, maybe you can announce it for our youth.
We want to see Bigger Than Hip Hop for my people's dead prayers.
Word up, y'all. It's Bigger Than Hip Hop. Hip Hop.
Fake records. When it hit, you feel no pain. White folks that controls your brain, I know better than that. That's game, man, we ready for that. Two soldiers head of the pack. Matter of fact, who got it?
What?
And where my army at? Rather attack and not react. Back to beats, it don't reflect on how many records get sold on sex, drugs, and rock and roll. Whether your projects put on hold in the real world. These just people with ideas. They just like me and you when the smoke and cameras disappear again. The real world. It's bigger than all these fake records. Wait, poor folks got the millions and my woman's disrespected. If you check 1, 2, my word of advice to you is just relax. Just do what you got to do. If that don't work, then kick the facts. If you a fighter, rider, bada, flame igniter, crowd exciter, or you wanna just get hot and just say it. But then if you a lie, pants on fire, wolf cry, agent with a why, I'm gonna know it when I play it. It's bigger than
hip hop. It's bigger than shot Biggie Smalls. If we don't get them, they gon' get us all. I'm down for running up on them in they city hall. We ride for y'all, all my dogs, stay real. Don't think these record deals gon' feed your season, pay your bills, because they not. MCs get a little bit of love and think they hot. Talk about how much money they got. All y'all records sound the same. I'm sick of that fake thug R&B rap scenario all day on the radio. Same scenes in the video, monotonous material. Y'all don't hear me though. These record labels slang our tapes like dope. You could be next in line and sign and still be writing rhymes and broke. You'd rather have a Lexus or Justice, a dream or some substance, a Beamer, a necklace or freedom. Sippin' like me, don't play a hate, I just stay awake. This real hip hop and it don't stop till we get the popo off the block. They call it
hip hop. It's bigger than
crazy shit. We keep it crunk up, John Blaze and shit. What? DP's got that crazy shit. We keep it crunk up, John Blaze and shit.
What do you wanna do?
DP's got that crazy shit. We keep it crunk up, John Blaze and shit.
What you want to?
DP's got that crazy shit. We keep it crunk up, John Blaze and shit. DP's got that crazy shit. We keep it crunk up.
willkommen im Club.
Kurz vor Weihnachten sagen der Plattenpapst und MC Spontan noch einmal willkommen im Club. Beide haben eine Menge neue Sachen am Start und werden die Funken der Festtagsstimmung auf jeden zum Überspringen bringen. Gerockt wird quer durch Deutschland und deshalb auch in eurer Nähe. Main Concept, Reptile und die drei Blumentopf-MCs Holunder, Kung Shu und Mike Specht kicken auf der zweiten Future Freestyle Session das, womit sie sich einen Namen gemacht haben. Freestyles, Freestyles und nochmal Freestyles. Mixer Reward Deluxe präsentiert diese Tour, die quer durch die Landen und das deutschsprachige Umland zieht und im Dezember zum Hip-Hop-Highlight werden lässt.
Wir backen Fensterplätzchen bis zum nächsten Eiszeit. Wenn ihr dabei seid, kriegt ihr ein Highlight. Bei uns gibt's Fensterplätzchen bis zum nächsten Eiszeit.
Mixer Reward Deluxe präsentiert die Hip-Hop Jam 2000, auf der zum Ende des Jahres nochmal die Bühne gerockt wird. Das großartige Line-Up repräsentiert Germany's Real Hip-Hops aus allen Teilen des Landes, angeführt von den Ruhrpottlern Kreuzfeld und Jakob und Dieke. Berlin wird in Form von KMC, das Department, Piranha, den Analphabeten, Casey the Rookie und Co. vertreten sein. Letzten Endes stehen auch Räumer Key 2 featuring ABS und Lynn neben dem neuesten 4Music-Signing MC Clouseau auf der Bühne. Die Tour geht weiter.
Das ist euer Auftrag, ihr hattet kaum Kraft für ein autonomes Bewusstsein. Mit der Zeit nach Solution soll damit Schluss sein.
Yeah. Wieder zurück bei Mixi Raw Deluxe mit Danny, Anthony. Okay, started with Lewis's Lounge and then you came in contact with Rockus.
Yeah,
how does it came to be, and what's the story behind?
We kind of knew each other for a while, you know, through different people. I know Danny met with Jared, but someone who works with us now, his name is Perry Landisberg. He's one of our partners. Basically came here for, you know, for an employment opportunity, and was able to turn it into a relationship and a whole structured deal. Mm-hmm. You know? So that's pretty much how it happened, you know, through Perry and just going out to clubs and knowing each other.
And the philosophy from Rockus and Lewis's Lounge, you would say it's in the same direction, so that's why it worked out together.
Totally.
Yeah.
Like, we could have signed to a lot of different major labels, but it was
for sure.
You know, we felt more comfortable being here because we shared the same view, you know, in terms of up-and-coming artists and breaking new artists and stuff like that, you know.
Okay, the artists, you chose them for the first Lewis's Lounge, and for now, how the collection of the artists, how much influence you have now at this time?
Same. I mean, it's like a... It's a round table, you know? It's like we come up with stuff, they come up with stuff, and, you know, we benefit. We both benefit from it, you know?
Yeah.
So, definitely.
Now, Lyricist Lounge is worldwide so popular. What can we expect in the future from Lyricist Lounge? What are you planning?
Yeah.
We're
planning on...
Like Black Sean, secret.
Yeah, well... If everything goes right, we should be out in Europe in February. We'll be setting up a European tour.
Definitely.
European tour.
Yeah.
With American MCs or German?
Yeah, like American MCs, and we probably like have an open mic like in every show that we do, so we can put on some local talent, you know.
Like
because that's
in the
what
days.
We are about. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You know.
Definitely.
We always like to keep, you know, the origin of it alive. You know what I mean? Because that's what it's all about. Just putting on new talent. That's what our whole thing is about. You know.
Yeah. Yeah, you're also rappers, mate. We can do a little freestyle.
Oh, yeah, whatever, man. What's up? You got beatbox going on, right?
Okay, a little bit. I'll make the beatbox. All right.
You gonna start it off?
No, I'm not rapping.
Oh, no, he's not rapping. All right. Yeah. We up in NYC at the Rockus office, chilling, trying to get this little thing off. We trying to get our little PR out to the world. It's like, Germany, what's happening? Hello to the girls, hello to the guys, doing it. What up with the spies? Chill, keep it on the low profile. I got my man D. Castro chilling with me. We gonna break it down simply. It goes one for the money, two for the crump. Three for the top of the line. Come on. One for the money. Two for the crown. Yeah, three for the... We about to drop in the dime. It goes... Boom,
yeah, check it out, y'all. Check it out, y'all. Real quick now. Yo, chilling out here. Get the beat right. Get the beat right. Cooling here with my crew. check out Lyricist Lounge Volume 2. That's all I really gotta say. Comes out in November 28th. Yeah.
November 28th, y'all. Lyricist Lounge Volume 2 in stores. Check for it internationally. You know what I mean?
Word. No doubt.
Smooth.
Gib mir den Beatbox, ich werde das noch übersetzen. Ich werde am Mikrofon schwätzen und meine Rämer wie andere Leute Schachbretter setzen. Hier bin ich bereit, am November krieg ich Ständer und mit Lyricist Lounge, ich weiß genau, wir reisen durch alle Länder. Denn ich nehme das Mikrofon, komm wie ein Scheich durch seine Gewänder. Eggers Reihe Jetlag und hat die krassen Augenränder. Doch ich weiß genau, dass ich die Welt mit dem Flow veränder. Weil Robert Reed kommt an Mikrofon ran, der kriegt einen Ständer, ist kein Blender. Wie das Licht und ich bin nicht ganz dicht, aber Anthony und Danny. Robin Green am Mikrofon, ich heiß nicht Kenny, bin nicht dead, auch nicht wack, sondern bin hier ein bisschen Jetlag.
Lyricist Lounge, boy. Volume 2, check for
it. Get it in stores,
it's real, bro.
Word up. It's live.
Gotta turn it this way, though.
Yeah.
Mit der Frühstück am Bahnhof 12 Inch legen Echo Rausch ihren zweiten Joint auf Masters of Broadway vor. Über den sehr schmufen Beat flowen die Münchner mit überzeugender Lässigkeit. Vielleicht Münchens neue Hoffnung.
Auslaufen, absperren, ein von meinen People mieten. Im DFL bieten, mal hören, was die Beat zu bieten. Augen rot, Schlüpfe blau, die Schwarzfahrt verbieten. Früher nicht so geil, früher eher Essence.
Die Mindclouders teilen sich auf dieser 12-Inch das Wachs mit Murs. Beide Seiten sind klare A-Sides und wieder einmal repräsentiert die West Coast aufs Ganze. Rubiks haben auf Thinking Aloud mit Talib Kweli ein zurzeit sehr hoch gehandeltes Feature am Start. Allerdings wäre diese 12-Inch auch ohne ihn eine Bombe. Für Beats hat neben Arsenic und Geology auch Jay Rawls gesorgt. Der New Yorker Rapper, Produzent und DJ Jay Life ist endlich mit seiner Scheibe am Start. Nachdem es Probleme mit verschiedenen Plattenfirmen gab, hat er The Best Part einfach selbst rausgebracht. Gute Sache, das Ding ist der Hammer.
Shit like this to leave skid marks. The way you point blank, unchained pit box. Or like the party people's in the place.
Nachdem DJ MB bereits Loop Troop mit Beats veredelt hat, kommt er jetzt mit seiner Ambitious Art EP. Auf drei Stücken wird er von seinen Loop Troop Homies unterstützt. Die restlichen Stücke sind instrumental und ganz klar die Bombe.
Wir sind jetzt hier, Mixi Raw Deluxe, bei Rockers, jetzt hier mit Mr. Black Sean, yeah. Executive Producer von Lyricist Lounge und A&R. Okay, nice to have us in our show.
Yeah, nice to be here, nice to be here.
Yeah, the first question is, under which aspect you choose the artist for the Lyricist Lounge?
I try to choose the dopest people, you know, just like... who we have an idea of who we feel like we want to work with, you know what I mean? And out of that, you know, usually those people or that list of peoples are dope MCs, and out of that, see how accessible they are and try to politic and hook it up.
Where you go? You go in clubs, or you know, as a cousin of his, you got good style.
Yeah, it's a little of that. It's a little of that. It's a little of, record business being record business, calling somebody up from the label, knowing the artist's manager.
Yeah.
Getting a contact so I can eventually get to the person I need to go to.
Okay.
Or just bumping into somebody, you know. When we did Beanie Siegel, I had saw him perform in San Francisco.
San Francisco?
And I wanted I wanted to get a song with him, so, I just was like, yeah, we gotta do this. We'll hook up when we get back to New York, but here's my card, and we'll take it from there. And spoke to his manager, so it was just a matter of solidifying the phone call.
Yeah, and the Lyricist Lounge, for some people, it's like, that's the first feature, and after that, some of them get bigger, some of them
Yeah,
gone.
True.
How about that for some young MCs who get through the Lucis launch into the hip hop business?
Yeah.
How's that? You help them to get further or?
Well, you know, the Lyricist Lounge is definitely a stepping stone to getting larger. I mean, there have been some artists who've done good shows there and good things have happened. You know, I can say that. On the prior projects, Lyricist Lounge Volume 1, you know, we had a lot of good unknown, known, a good mix of both type of artists on there to present a package that the people felt. So that is why we had a demand for Volume 2.
Yeah.
And that is, like, on the same vibe and, you know, premises we put this together, you know, still get some lesser known artists and couple them with some more larger artists. Most of the artists that we work with do have some stature and have some credibility and have been doing their thing.
Okay.
But, you know, even so, we still put some underground kids on there as well.
Cool, cool.
And how's your relationship between you and the Lyricist Lounge and how came it back then?
Been cool with the lounge for years, you know what I mean? So I've been going to the lounge before, was involved with them on a business aspect, so I always had respect for what they did. You know, Danny and Anthony started that company when they were 16.
16,
you know? Yeah, so that's real, you know what I mean? So I felt that, and when we hooked up with them to do the first project, you know, it was a good thing. I think, you know, it gave a lot of underground MCs a showcase for them to display their joints, you know? So doing the second project, it was just natural.
You got this policy of freedom for the artists. They got their rights own. Is it?
Yeah.
You're smiling. Why?
Because, I mean, that's the quote-unquote thing. Ruckus is free. But, you know, like every other business, it's a business as well. And we try to, you know, of course, deal with our artists in an equitable and fair manner. And unfortunately, just not all businesses deal with their people like that. So.
Okay.
But, finish.
No, cool. Okay. Alles klar, jetzt checken wir Body Rock ab. Miss Mr. Q-Tip Tash. Und Almost Staff. Ich wünsche euch viel Spaß und thanks for giving some cool statement.
Yeah, not a problem.
Mr. Black Sean.
Peace, peace,
Body Rock.
Almost Staff, Lyricist Lounge, Raucous, forever.
Check it out.
All right, you gotta slow down. I'm trying to. I only took a little bit of Spanish. You got. I hear what you're saying, but yeah, I'm feeling you. Yo, all my people in Brooklyn, and you know where hot. I said, bitch,
don't stop the body rock.
All my people in Queens, in the land in between, said we
don't stop the body rock.
Shouting at L.I., so you know we fly, said we
don't stop the body rock.
From the east to the west, so we take it to your chest, said we
don't stop,
check that out, y'all. I'm in the lab with Ab, I got the band, the fab. My man T-E-S-H, take it to your breastplate. It's the mighty Mos Def, complete the trilogy. Just shot myself a dime, see all you feeling me. Son, I'm wicked and nice when I'm on facility. Let me take a sec to review what I wrote. Mos Def and the style far fresh. Okay, it's dope, let's record this. They gonna warn this. And all area crew is gonna applaud this. And when we step to the play, parts flawless. My man T-A-S-H, style glory, great, 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 great.
And up next we got Katash with that West Coast rhyming, bombing with the style as dangerous as mountain climbing. Cause the alky words I'm spitting be twisting while you listening. Plus I'm in this motherfucker with the liquid coalition that'll leave you in position. Twisted backwards like yoga while you staring down my throat like, is he drunk or is he sober? Who knows? All I know is Tash got flows and got the technique to get the ladies out of their clothes. I've been overly exposed to the 40-yos and chickens, so I'ma keep it pumping till the beat stop kicking or till the plot thickens. Cause this is how we do catastrophe, most death in the brother man.
What's up, Tash? Hey, yo, Tip can't call it. Chill is most is death and you alcoholic. I'ma be surfing that thing that's worth dealing. Hypodermically, shoot up your feeling. Figuratively, speaking of course now. Old and greedy men seeking this course now. What we gonna do? Eradicate them. Shoot them from the gym. They beat disease.
Tash, love, are you ready to rock the mic?
Q-Tip,
are you ready to rock the mic?
Most Def,
are you ready to rock the mic? We got the universal style that you got to like. And ain't nobody stepping up when we got the mic. So turn the AC up cause it's hot tonight. Until the right early morning, we'll be rocking you all. Don't stop the body rock.
cause I'm next to flex. And I'm technically advanced to turn you on like cyber sex. So in less than 2 sex, I blind the seas like Tom and Dolby. With the science that'll leave they brain cells frying slowly. Cause solely I flow with express written consent. From the underground, it's coast to coast I represent. Cause getting bent, I do, but I'm doper than Sharn. Plus the way I put it down could burn the perm off Big Worm. So peep this private screening of the last action hero that be freezing rappers dead in their tracks like Sub-Zero. Cause Rico ain't no joke, I eat your flows and your beat up. Rappers even feel my presence when I'm home with my feet up.
What you skeet up or treat up? Relax and pull a seat up. Make your landlord turn the heat up. Got the opposition shook like Tiger Woods about to tee up. Sunday here's no competition with the clear most definition. MC screaming down for years, can rhyme without their mom's permission. You just a youngin' coming out, getting gas to run your mouth. Wildin' on the runabout, baby Paul, you coming out. Barking at you on about, but son, you know to come about. When most that flow bumpin', you don't nothing. Don't you know nothing? My crew go hunting. We keep it on the norm, then we transform something. And while we do it, you bounce to it. The cops wanna stop the body rock, but don't do it.
Dynamite, like Jimmy JJ. Hey. Slop down Pen A somewhere at LA. Hey. Now we got to bump like Voltron. Tattoo the bump, most shoot the bonton. Repeatedly, I must drop on E. ABS, I bust down facility. TRACT is the MC. It's the LL inside the place. B.
Are you ready to rock the mic? Are you ready to rock the mic? Are you ready to rock the mic? We got the universe above that you got the like. But ain't nobody stepping up when we got the mic. So turn your AC up cause it's hot tonight. And tell the bright early ball we'll be rocking you all. All my people out in Queens, you know you're hot. They say, don't stop the body rock. All my people out in Brooklyn, and you know we're hot. I said, don't stop the body rock. Shout in the L.I., and you know we're fly. I said, don't stop the body rock. All the people on the greens in the name.
Hey, baby, I like it, boy.
Here in the mix.
Okay, Mixi Raw Deluxe, heute hier, Pharamond. Nice to have you in our show again.
No doubt,
The people, the hip-hop heads, they know you since way back from Organized Confusion.
Right.
And the younger hip-hop heads, since your last joint, you dropped out. It's very famous, incredible. I want to give you props from all the hip-hop heads out there. And how does the work came to be to Raucous Records? I got done with that.
I mean, it's good, man. When I went out solo, you know, I had a couple of offers from different labels, and I really chose to come to Raucous because of their track record, underground record, different artists that they have that inspired me. I figured it would be like one big family if I came over here to work with Tlaib and Mos and so on and so forth.
Which artist inspires you when you say?
At Raucous? Tlaib Kweli, you know, all the work he's done with Reflection and Mos and, you know, all the artists here in their own different way really inspire hip-hop. And it's like, you know, if I put out an album and then another artist has to follow that up, it inspires you to step your game up, you know, like these cats are putting out classic albums, Black Star and so forth. So that inspires me to try and come with the same integrity.
The whole album, you produced the whole album also?
No, I did like 5 songs.
Yeah.
The other artists were Diamond D, DJ Scratch from EPMD, Alchemist, and Lee Stone.
Yeah, and since Organized Confusion, a lot of things happened in the business and in the music. How would you describe your own development through these times?
I mean, basically for me, it's just letting it out. You know, no difference. Actually, it's easier because it's less compromise, and it's like whatever I feel, I just spit it right out onto the tape, vomit it right out. And I'm gonna back it 100% because that's what I'm feeling right now.
Yeah. I read an interview with Organized Confusion where there was the inspiration were way back from Ultramagnetic MC, is that right?
Definitely. I mean, Kool Keith said G.
Yeah, man. Ultramagnetic.
exciting.
No doubt. The whole Ultra movement.
Yeah.
I never did
a track with them.
No. I've been thinking about doing something with
Yeah.
Kid. We'll see. But I mean, that first single that they put out, it changed hip hop, you know what
yeah.
I'm saying?
In which way?
I mean, lyrically it was different. Flow, it was different. Beat, it was different. It was like one of the first records that made me go out and buy a box radio just
okay.
so I could walk
okay.
around and blast it, you know?
Yeah.
You mean Critical Beatdown?
Yeah, okay. That album is to this day in top 10 albums of all time.
Yeah.
Absolutely dope.
What else?
Takes a Nation of Millions.
Okay.
Low End Theory. De La Soul. Road to the Riches, G-Rap, you know, those are the artists that inspire me.
Yeah.
I read about you that on stage you're Pharaoh Munch,
mm-hmm.
and when you go off stage you're Troy.
Right.
Is that some kind of split personality, or what do you mean with that? Different persons.
I wouldn't say it's psychotic enough to be split. But it's definitely two different people in that Pharaoh allows me to get all my aggression out. I'm real reserved, introverted. I'm not real loud, you know, but as Pharaoh on stage, it's an outlet for all that. I mean, emotionally, I'm like a sponge. People come to me with their problems, I absorb them. I hold my problems in and I have deep passion for what other people's concerns are. So Pharaoh just allows me to vent all that stuff out because we all need to release, you know? And that's a blessing of what Pharaoh is to me, you know?
But Pharaoh Munch is not only the aggressive side, it's all sides of the emotion.
Exactly,
no
I problem. Mean, and it's a platform to let out those emotions, you know? Some people wait a whole month just gathering information, and then on a Sunday they'll just cry for no reason or argue for no reason.
Okay.
I mean, what hip hop does for me is it allows me to, you know, release all of my emotions, like you just said, sad, love, hate, anger, racial, politics, or just, you know, telling people more about who I am, you know. And that's a great thing with hip hop, you know.
Is it a kind of personal therapy?
Definitely.
Definitely. That's
definitely.
What hip hop is all about.
Yeah. Especially the last album.
Especially the last album was like coming back in the minds of the hip hop
right,
heads,
right.
spitting them in
yeah.
the face.
Right, right. It was
very successful in that way.
Right. It was yeah. real therapeutic for me, you know, that last album.
Okay, now. We want to watch the video or no from Lyricist Lounge.
Alright.
Okay, gleich sind wir wieder da mit Mr. Pharaoh Munch mit nach Oh No. Let's start.
Yeah. One for the trouble, two for the bass. Welcome to the great incredible paper chase. Keep your boots laced if you want to keep pace.
Oh no! They scared to hustle. It's been 7 days, the same clothes. Ask them originals, cause they know. All step, Nate Dogg, very cold. Step away from the mic, they too cold. The phone might fracture your nose.
My name, say my name. Observe how I stake my claim. I independently laid down and paid my game. My own two ways, my flame, cause riding ain't my thing. I earned what they said I wouldn't. I got it the way they said I couldn't. But now I'm getting it and they whole grill is crooked. Mad cause I'm getting kicked out for my bookings. When y'all was asking permission, I just stepped up and took it. What? The kids better buy my rookie card now. Cause after this year, the price ain't coming down. And if you got a joint bubbling, then get money now. Cause in a minute, there's gonna be some real trouble coming out. Just a warning. As usual, cats won't heed it. The hard-headed always gotta feel it to believe it. Shame the jealous gaze is too short to see it. But when they face it, the semen, they know it in agreement. We can play nice and decent, but dirty like the 7-1 precinct. Call it a day, you'll make it a long evening. You keep on scheming and give me some more reason. I had them women in your mama's church screaming, Lord Jesus. Harder than y'all, cause I'm smarter than y'all. I know the deep down, it got to be bothering y'all. Pay attention, watch flock go get larger than y'all. Pour your pride on the rocks, make it swallow it all.
Oh no! Look at who they let in the back door. From Long Beach
to Brooklyn, they know we rock from the east to west coast. Queens salute, you better know. Step away from the mic, they too cold.
Very contagious rap should be trapped in cages. Through stages of whack, the spouse raps ablaze, and then it amazes me how you claim thugs to go two ways without SkyTel pages. I'm intellectual, pass more essays than motorcade, police parades. Do we sell a more beef than delays? Thus, what I vent is just what you lust to vent is eat relay. Hallelujah, Pharaoh Mantra, do ya maintain the same frame of mind? Screw ya, get the picture, sit your seat, your creature with scripture. I'm equipped to rip your reach ya. Pharaoh and Moses, verbal osmosis, coast to coast. We boast to be the most explosive here, ferocious, the lyrical prognosis. The dose, just leaving you mentally unfocused there. MCs, just come on round. You're the next contestant, so I'll catch a beat down. Don't be hesitant, sound cracks the sediment. It's evident we medicine for your whole town. Sky's the limit, game's infinite when I'm in it. All windows are sitting, seeing me when I'm in it. Rap, we got it on lock, man. Stop that. Put that mic back down, boy. Drop that. Pharaoh's flows blow shows like afros. We hate y'all, though. That's my Nate Doggo.
Oh, no. Cause they scared to hustle. It's been 7 days, the same clothes. Ask them originals, cause they know. All step, Nate Dogg, the big roll. Step away from the mic, they too cold. The funk mic fracture your nose. Nose, 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 nose. Oh no! They scared to hustle. It's been 7 days, the same clothes. Ask them originals, cause they know. All step, Nate Dogg, the big roll. Step away from the mic, they too cold. The funk mic fracture your nose, 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 nose. Oh no! Look at who they let hit the back door. From Long Beach to Brooklyn, they know. We rock from the east to west coast. Queens salute, you better know. Step away from the mic, they too cold. The funk mic fracture your nose, nose, nose.
Oh, we on the air.
New York. Der seit mehreren Wochen von der Polizei gesuchte Wu-Member ODB ist in New York verhaftet worden. Nachdem er aus einer Entzugsklinik in L.A. geflüchtet war, ist er letzte Woche bei der Release-Party des neuen Wu-Tang-Albums auf der Bühne erschienen. Nun ist er in einem Fastfood-Restaurant in NY verhaftet worden. Als er mehreren Autogrammjägern geduldig sein Tag aufs Papier setzte, wurde er von den Cops gecatcht. Dumm gelaufen. New York. Das amerikanische Hip-Hop-Label wie Tommy Boy oder seit kurzem auch Def Jam Außenstellen in Deutschland betreiben, erscheint nicht unbedingt so außergewöhnlich. Jetzt nahm Groove Attack als erste deutsche Hip-Hop-Instanz die andere Richtung über den großen Teich, um in New York City ein Büro zu eröffnen.
In erster Linie Groove Attack und Super Rappin nach außen präsentieren und so hoffentlich so eine Art Buzz kreieren, wo Leute sagen, ah, was ist das? Ich hab gesehen die neue J. Rose oder Five Dog oder wie auch immer. Und Super Rappin, was ist das für ein Label? Und oh, ich sehe jetzt irgendwie, es gibt so eine Nummer hier in Manhattan, vielleicht rufe ich an irgendwie, frag nach Promos oder schick mein Demo oder wie auch immer.
Nachdem das Kölner Label durch den Super Rappin Sampler und vor allem durch das weltweit exklusive Signing von Ex-Tribe-Member Five Dog auch in den Staaten für Aufmerksamkeit gesorgt hat, will Groove Attack den Weg jetzt einen dicken Schritt weitergehen.
Groove Attack hat schon eine Geschichte in Europa, sagen wir mal. Und jetzt müssen wir hier anfangen. Und hoffentlich kommen auch neue Künstler. Wir schaffen irgendwie genug Geld, machen irgendwie genug, verkaufen genug Produkt, um allmählich wachsen zu können.
New York. Ein Back-to-the-Roots-Album wird es demnächst von Rapper Nas geben. The Lost Tapes of Nas wird neben neuen Songs und Remixe bekannter Klassiker noch unveröffentlichtes Material der guten alten Zeit beinhalten. Das Ding soll ab 23. Januar erhältlich sein. Zuvor gibt es am 19. Dezember noch ein Nas-Projekt namens QB's Finest. Diese Scheibe stellt eine Hommage an den New Yorker Stadtteil Queensbridge dar und featuret sämtliche Artists wie Marley Marl, Mobb Deep, Big Noid und einer Menge Nachwuchsrapper aus dem Borough.
Sway Tim's on my beats, make my cypher complete. Weather cruising in a six cab. I'm on tarot deep, I can't call it.
Alles klar, wieder zurück mit Pharamond. You joined on the Lewis's Lounge, oh no.
How does it came to be, and what does the Lyricist Lounge especially mean for you?
I mean, they represent like a pure brand of hip hop. You know, back in the days, back in Brooklyn, they had artists coming
Cyphers
out. Cyphers and heads freestyling. And it definitely gave artists an outlet to perform. And I would go to the shows and such artists as Biggie and so forth.
You've been there back in the days?
I never performed there, but I hosted.
Okay.
Right. And these albums, you know, are a collective of a lot of those artists, you know, who benefited. Just a collection of MCs, and I think it's a blessing to be a part of that whole thing. Okay.
Was there back in the days something like a platform, a Lyricist Lounge for you as you started?
I mean, we didn't really go that route. We was more on a scientific level as far as we listened to what was out there.
Mm-hmm.
And then it got stale for us, and then we was like, that's whack. We're gonna show you how we would do it. Not so much to be better than, but what was missing from the game. What was missing from the game at that time, we was like, you know, we were artists, so we wanted more visual rhymes, and we wanted like to throw the whole Marvel comic book thing into the game. Okay. And
fantasy world style.
Exactly, and
mm-hmm.
That's the kind of like edge we brought to our freestyles, you know, or whatever. And we put some demos together and we went out and people were like, oh shit, you know. So never really was a struggle for us to get signed.
That was?
Who was this? Damn, so what, 10 or so years ago?
All right.
And never was a struggle to get signed. It's just after we got signed, we had all these problems with record labels and, you know, so on and so forth.
Is that a reason why you get signed at Raucous?
I mean, Raucous for me represented a guerrilla label that worked music from the ground up. And I knew that I was going to come here with raw material, and I knew I was going to have to make a single that would have to work its way from the street to the club, to the mixtape, to the DJs,
okay.
A record that DJs would hear and be like, oh man, I don't care who this is, I want to play this record, you know. So knowing their track record of working the street and the underground, I was like, that would be perfect for this record, you know what I'm saying?
We read in your biography that Simon Says is a song who acknowledged to the brain, but mm-hmm. also to the hooligan type, which
right.
means to the ghetto people and to the people who are very rough and something like that. So it's also this split thing between the brain shit and the tough shit.
Right. I mean, that's the beauty of the song, you know, to me. When I was writing it, matter of fact, when I was doing the beat, the reaction that it gave me, you know, I was just in the house like, oh shit, crazy.
I think everybody was on there.
Yeah.
Everybody is hearing the track and thought, what? Mm-hmm. What a bomb.
Right. And so I'm just, you know, working on the beat and like make the drums simple.
Yeah.
And keep it straightforward, you know, on some head nod. And I sat there for a minute and I analyzed it and I was like, you know, I don't want to overanalyze the song, come too wordy. If I just put the raw emotion that the song made me feel at first, it should work. And I just was like, it made me feel, you know, crazy, and it made me feel unraveled. So I tried to put those type of vocals on there. And I was like, they played this beat in a club and I was on stage, what would I tell people to do? You know what I'm saying?
Okay. The next thing we have to expect from you, I heard you're doing a new LP, is
right.
that right?
Mm-hmm.
And what is with your old partner?
Mm-hmm.
Did you work again with him together
right.
on the same name, or?
Can we respect the reunion of Organized?
Right now, Prince is still working on his solo material.
Mm.
It's hard at work on it. I'm working on another solo album for Raucous, and it's prospects, but Organized Confusion fans, trust in us so much and expect a lot from us, you know, not just something that we put together. So in order for us to make that album, I mean, it would have to be a perfect situation between artist and label, between me and him. Like, he has some things he wants to say solo, and I mean, we owe that to our fans. So like, if I do another Organized Confusion album, it's gonna be, you know, 150%, you know what I'm saying? And I'm gonna concentrate on that and that only, you know, so.
Step by step.
Right.
Time will tell.
Time will tell.
And now, you see your video, Simon Seth, the incredible joint, yes, the last year.
All right.
And thanks for taking time.
No doubt.
Get up! Simon said he could get up. Throw your hands in the sky.